An adiabatic turbine with a power output of 7.5 megawatts receives steam at 4.5 megapascals, 700 degrees Celsius, and 60 meters per second, and it exhausts the steam at 100 kilopascals, 200 degrees Celsius, and 130 meters per second. Determine the mass flow rate of the steam and the isentropic efficiency of the turbine. As usual, try pausing here to solve this problem yourself before watching the solution. This is the first example for the isentropic efficiency main lecture. The link to that 8-minute lecture and all the other examples and lectures of the thermo course are found in the description below. The isentropic efficiency of turbines was defined in the main lecture video as the actual turbine's output over the isentropic turbine's output. From the first law, we have that the energy in is mass flow rate times specific enthalpy and the kinematic term at the entrance, 1, and that the energy out is that work output plus the mass flow rate times the specific enthalpy and the kinematic term at the exit, 2. Since this is an adiabatic turbine, there is no heat transfer. Therefore, for the isentropic work output, we'll need the enthalpy values, with H2 being that of the isentropic case H2S, the mass flow rate, and because we're actually getting the velocity information, we'll include it here, even though we have already proven that these values are usually negligible. This means that we need to find the mass flow rate first anyways. Since this expression for actual work output is practically the same, except for H2 instead of H2S to calculate the actual work, not the isentropic work, and we have the work value for the actual turbine, we can solve for the mass flow rate. The two missing terms here are H1 and H2. But since we have pressure and temperature information, we can use the steam tables to find H1 for P1 and T1, and then do the same to find H2 for P2 and T2. We substitute the values for specific enthalpy, for velocity, knowing that we need to correct for units, and the work, and this way we find the mass flow rate. Now, going back to the isentropic work case, we need H2S. That term is the specific enthalpy at the exit for the isentropic case, meaning that we need to find the entropy at 1 and assume that the entropy is still the same at 2. We're now looking to find H2S from S2S. Since we have P1 and T1, we go to our steam tables to find S1, which again is the same as S2S. We look for H2S in the superheated tables for steam at 100 kilopascals, since that is the exit pressure, and we see that we need to interpolate between these two values of specific entropy to find the specific enthalpy. We do that simple interpolation, links to those lectures below, and we find the specific enthalpy of 2, assuming an isentropic process H2S. And this is all we're missing. To find the isentropic output, we substitute H1, which is the same for the actual or the isentropic case, H2S, which we just found, the velocities, once again accounting for the units, and the mass flow rate we found earlier. And with this value for the isentropic work output, we find the isentropic efficiency of the turbine, which was the second question. If you want to check out other examples for the isentropic efficiency topic, make sure to check out the links I left down in the description below, where you'll find the links to the other lectures of the thermodynamics course, as well as other engineering courses. Thanks for watching!